Hey guys, Vinny with GHL here.
And I'm Richard with GHL.
And today we're here to talk to you about the Ion Director.
So Vinny, what is the Ion Director?
Well, to start off, the Ion Director is a testing mechanism which will test for parameters like calcium, magnesium, nitrate, potassium, and sodium.
So Vinny, what are some of the other capabilities and benefits of the Ion Director?
Well, the Ion Director will do data logging, it'll do charting, and based on the outcome of each test result, it'll make automatic adjustments to existing dose schedules.
So in what ways can we connect to the Ion Director?
Well, when it comes to connectivity, you have three options. You have GHL Connect app, which is an app that's available for both iOS and Android. You can connect to it through the MyGHL cloud servers. So wherever you are in the world, you'll be able to check in on your tank and see what the last parameters were, as well as go back and track the history of your test results. And the third option would be the GHL Control Center program, which is a Windows-based program.
So let's see the Ion Director in action.
Let's do it.
Excellent.
Okay, so before we get started with the Ion Director testing, let's first talk about what we have here on the table. First up, we have the Ion Director, and connected to it, we have the GHL doser, and for the brains of the device, we have a Prophylux 4 controller. Next up, we have our two bottles of reference fluids, followed by our wastewater container. The tank we have here will simulate a display tank or a sump. The water that's inside it has been made specially for us and verified by an ICP lab. And in this bottle, we have our sample water, which is the same water as what's in our tank. And behind this label, we have the printed concentrations of this sample water. And now I'm going to start a manual test on the GHL Connect app. As soon as I press start, I'm going to start a stopwatch so that you guys can see in real time how long it takes to do a test with an Ion Director.
Okay, so now that the test has started, let's go over the steps that are involved with each test. The first step begins with a flush cycle. Here is where old water is removed from the water sample tube so that new water can be used for testing. This process makes it possible for the Ion Director to test with a fresh sample of water each and every time. After the flush cycle, the Ion Director will move on to the next step. The sensor inside the Ion Director will now be calibrated using the first calibration point. As you can see, the Ion Director is now being fed the first reference fluid. The back and forth motion, which is happening now, allows the sensor to stabilize in less time without sacrificing any of the Ion Director's accuracy. This process takes about 3 minutes to complete. In the meantime, let's talk a little bit more about the flush cycle. As I mentioned earlier, the purpose of the flush cycle is to remove old water from the sample tube so the Ion Director can test with a fresh sample of water. During the flush cycle, the old water is pumped out through a tube which is connected to the back of the Ion Director. The other end of this tube runs back into the aquarium. The only water that comes out of this wastewater port will be the water sample itself and the reference fluids used for the sensor calibration. After the first calibration is completed, the Ion Director is fed a sample of your aquarium water. Just like in the last step, the pump head will begin moving back and forth as the Ion Director waits for the sensor to stabilize. This process will also take about 3 minutes to complete. For the final step, the Ion Director is now fed the second reference fluid. This process will be identical as the previous steps. Once the sensor stabilizes, the Ion Director will provide the test results.
Now that the test is done, let's see our results. And now let's compare those results with the results from our expected concentrations.
So now that we've seen the ion director in action, let's talk about some of the questions we've been getting lately.
Okay.
What is the accuracy on it?
The max error for calcium, magnesium, potassium, and sodium will be 3%. And for nitrate, the max error will be only 5%.
What's the sample size?
Sample size will be 5 milliliters.
How about the waste that it produces?
Also 5 mils.
Okay, how many pump heads does it take to run?
Ion director will require only 3 dosing pump heads.
Okay, as far as controlling it, do I need a Prophylux?
No, you don't. So you can run the ion director alongside a standalone GHL doser 2, or you can run it with a Prophylux 4 controller.
Thanks guys for watching this video. For the latest updates on the ion director, be sure to check out our website and FAQ page. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter to stay up to date with everything GHL. We've placed the links for all that in the description box below. Until next time, folks, take care.